What's going on, guys? Galileo the Bowler here, and today I'm going to be doing another rebuild at MLB The Show 20, but this time I'm going to be rebuilding the Miami Marlins. Now, like in my last two rebuilds I've done for the Padres, I had a hat. I do have a hat for the Marlins, but I just don't know where it is. Like, I probably wore it like a couple days ago, and then I just can't find it, so I just decided to do my hair and make a video. Like I said, we're going to be rebuilding the Miami Marlins. Our yearly goal is to reach 500 every season, above 500, and our contract goal is to make the postseason or win a division, one of those two. I don't remember. Reach the postseason. Yeah, I was right. Okay, so taking a look at our lineup, we have some upgrades to do. Jonathan VR is a good second baseman. Like, if I move him to second base, actually, let's go to roster for that. If I move him to second base, he becomes a 91 overall. But we got Isan Diaz in second base, who is an A potential. He is 74 overall. He has okay hitting attributes, but I wish it can be a little bit better. But Jonathan VR has outstanding defense in second base, and he did pretty good last season. It all just depends on how this team does. So I gotta make all the moves. So I'm gonna move him back to center field, because we have nobody in center field. Like, let's take a look. Yeah, we have nobody. We have Monte Harrison, but I don't think he's going to make his MLB debut anytime soon, so. Oh! And in right field, we got Harold Ramirez. Left field, we got Corey Dickerson, who turns out to be insane in this game, or just absolutely suck. The past few times I played franchise, Corey Dickerson actually did pretty well, averaging like 320, so I hope that happens with him right now. For shortstop, we got Miguel Rojas, which is okay. I mean, could be a little bit better. His defense is pretty good. Not pretty good, it's really good. Third base, we got Brian Anderson, who turns out to be insane later in the game. And second base, I already said Isan Diaz. First base is where we have to make a really big improvement, because Garrett Cooper is probably not the answer, or Jesus Aguilar. And then for catcher, we got Jorge Alfaro, who turns out to be good later in the game. Our closer needs some improvement. Relief, our pitching is gonna need some basically the whole team is gonna improve. So I'm gonna hire some new scouts, because even though they've done great in the past, but I don't know about the game, so I just trust the game. I'm gonna hire the most expensive scouts for every region, because I want my team to be really good in the future, so I'm gonna go ahead and do that. Okay, I improved my scouting, so now we are gonna sim to the draft day, because I believe we have the third overall spot. I'm pretty sure, if that makes any sense, but I'll see you guys in the draft day. All right, so we made it to the 2020 first year player draft, and as you can see, yeah, I was right, we had the third overall pick. So let's take a look.
6.5 hours late.
Where are the blue chips? Okay, there. I mean, we don't have that many blue chips. I hired the best scouts that were available, and I do have a lot of blue chips, but they can be a lot better. But first things first, I'm gonna close my closet, because that just distracts me. All right, now it looks clean, and then now we can start some draft. All right, let's take a look on some of these prospects. Since our scouting department didn't do very well in finding good prospects, I'm gonna go with Humberto Santana. Just look, I mean, yeah, 80 stamina. He has great hits per nine. He got really good walks per nine. He's okay at striking people out. He's got high velocity, he's got high break. That's basically what you need to look for. And he makes his MLB debut in 3 years, so why not? Our scouting department did poorly. So, all right, coming up in the competitive, what's this round called? Competitive balance round. Let's draft another player. I hope we can get like a good player, because our scouting department is trash and I wasted a lot of money on him. All right, for the next player that we're going for is gonna be Tommy Woodall. Got fantastic contact, basically like Tony Gwynn, Mr. Padre. He's got okay power. He's got really good fielding. So basically a future Tony Gwynn in our hands. So let's go for him. And he makes his debut in 2 years, which is perfect. Now, he is a third baseman, which means Brian Anderson's going to be there. But we can probably move Brian Anderson around. We never know. Or we can trade that guy to get someone better. Depends if he does well after the draft. So I did say that we need a first baseman, but this guy is going to take a long time to develop. But Tristan Abraham, he's got pretty good numbers. And he's 22, so he's going to be up there in age when we make him in the MLB. All right, I think this is going to be our last pick, so I got to make the best of it. Wish me luck. All right, for the next pick, we're going to go for Peter Cruz. This is our last 80 potential overall that has high scouting accuracy. I hope he turns out well. If not, I just wasted a pick. So, all right, Peter Cruz, and then we'll sim the rest of the draft. Now, please, scouting department, you did very bad. Please make me get really good players. All right, Humberto Santana is going to be of a potential. That is very good. I did very well. I am actually surprised because, oh my god, I did very good. I did very good. Umberto's gonna be a 92. Tommy's gonna be a 90. Tristan's gonna be an 84. Peter Cruz is gonna be an 86. I am probably the king in drafting, even though our scouting department, like I said a thousand times, did very bad. But still, I am the god at drafting players. All right, we gotta sign everyone to a contract because this is just insane. We are not letting anyone escape from our hands. That sounds very like, never mind. Just forget what I said. So at draft day, we are currently in second. Okay, that's kind of surprising, with a 34-28 record, with basically four games behind the Nats. I'm a sim to the trade deadline. And I hope we do good because we're actually doing pretty good and I might make some trade pieces at the end. So I'll meet you guys there. All right, so we're here in the trade deadline. Let's take a look on how everyone is doing. Jonathan VR, how are you doing? 77-2 OPS, okay. 14 home runs and a 257 batting average. Close to last season, maybe can be a little bit better, but he did play. He did play every game last season, so that's not gonna be the case this season, probably. Miguel Rojas, what about you? 759 OPS with a 282 batting average and 9 home runs. Okay. I mean, I guess he's basically only good in fielding, so I guess I'll take it. Corey Dickerson, I'm telling you, this guy's basically a cheat code. But look at his stats: 17 home runs, 328 batting average and a 918 OPS. That's what I like to see right there. Garrett Cooper, how are you doing? 10 home runs, a 327 batting average and a 911 OPS. I think everyone is just breaking out. I think that's why we're doing good. All right, move it on. Brian Anderson, this is basically why we drafted that other guy. I don't remember his name, but still. 13 home runs, 247 batting average and a 702 OPS. Yeah, that's something we gotta fix. Harold Ramirez, how are you doing? 93 games. Okay. 9 home runs, 293 batting average, and an 840 OPS. All right, I'll take that. Jorge Alfaro, he got 13 home runs. He got 245 batting average and a 725 OPS. Now, Isan Diaz, this is the guy I'm kind of worrying for. 730 OPS, 10 home runs. Decisions. This game, specifically franchise mode, makes you think hard. And it sucks, to be honest, because you either risk it or you just completely go for it and it turns out to be good. So I'm gonna take a risk here. I know it might sound a little stupid, but I'm gonna trade Isan Diaz. Why? He might turn out to be insane. I mean, he's got a lot of trade value. So, I mean, I don't know. I just don't think he's the person at second base. Sure, he has. No, never mind. Yeah, I'm done. For the first trade of the day, well, of the season, I should say. Like I said, we are trading Isan Diaz, but we are getting someone very, very good in return. So I think I won this trade, to be honest. I really don't know. Yeah. So we're trading Isan Diaz, Monte Harrison, and Jesus Aguilar. Wow, you guys might be wondering, why am I trading Jesus Aguilar? I mean, with 64 games, he's got a 250 batting average and a 728 OPS. But Garrett Cooper is basically taking his spot. I mean, with those great numbers, so he's gotta go. In return, we're getting Gleyber Torres. Okay, listen, just hear me out. Gleyber Torres, and then some relief pitchers that I just needed, and maybe can bring up soon in the future. So, yeah, I think we did a pretty equal trade. I don't know if I won the trade, but still, I think we did a pretty good trade. So, yeah. Gleyber Torres, welcome to the team. This is insane. I can't believe we just traded for Gleyber Torres. And he is having an outstanding season. Just take a look. Watch this. With 94 games up in his belt, he got 28 home runs, okay, in 94 games. 28 home runs, a 275 batting average, and a 914 OPS. And he's very cheap. I'll take that any day. I don't care if I risk giving away prospects. He is very, very good. I'll take that. And watch. I hope he goes up because I wanted to play second base. Let's check. He goes up like 8 overall points. That is crazy. Okay. Gleyber Torres, you are a brand new second baseman, my guy. Looking on my trade block, I don't know why we want to trade Jonathan VR. Let's take a look at his stats right now. I mean, he's doing okay, but I mean, it could be better. I mean, he's basically a second baseman, so maybe I can trade him for an actual center fielder. Let's take a look. I'm gonna do some shopping and I'll let you guys know what I get. All right, so I decided I am trading Jonathan VR because we are getting Whit Merrifield in exchange. Now, I know I said Jonathan VR is a second baseman and all of that. Whit Merrifield basically is a second baseman as well, but still, he's doing pretty good with 122 hits. He basically led the league in hits the last two seasons, so I won't be surprised if he does that this season as well. He has three triples so far. I mean, four triples. I'm sorry. He got 11 home runs. I mean, he doesn't have the greatest power. He's got 299 batting average and 815 OPS, and he basically has the same stats as Jonathan VR. He's way better in hitting wise, and he's got the same fielding attributes, except his arm strength is not high, but it doesn't matter. So I'll take that any day. And I think he is faster than... No, he is not faster than him. But, I mean, it's whatever. And we are getting Cam Gallagher since we are trading Francisco Cervelli. It's basically a hit or miss with this trade because Francisco Cervelli isn't doing... He's basically not doing anything for the team and isn't... And Cam Gallagher, I think that's how you say that name, he's not basically doing anything either. And I gotta add a pretty decent prospect. So I added a center fielder, Cameron Misner. I have no idea, but yeah. So Whit Merrifield, welcome to the Miami Marlins. We are happy to have you. Now I know if they're on a trade block, it doesn't mean we have to trade them, but it all just depends, to be honest. Okay, I think that's gonna do it for trades. If not, we can just start your free agency, which should be completely good because everyone else is doing pretty good. And I'll take it. I mean, our Harold Ramirez can be a little bit better, but still, I'll take it any day. And then we'll just fix our bullpen and our pitching staff and free agency, since that's when it's really gonna matter. And we have a really good budget. We're basically gonna make $2 million each week. So yeah, I'll take that any day. We are currently in third place. We are 9 games behind the Nats. Are we even close to the wild card? Yeah, we are basically 2 games behind, so we're not far. So let's see if they continue to break out and hopefully make the wild card. We never know. So I'll see you guys at the end of the season. All right, so we made it to the end of the season. We unfortunately did not make it. We had a pretty good record for it for being the Marlins, so I'll take that any day. Let's actually take a look on how our team did. We got some awards. Okay, first of all, let's take a look on the awards. Who did we get? A gold glove for Jorge Alfaro and Miguel Rojas. Okay, let's go. Let's take a look at our lineup. Whit Merrifield did very good. 15 home runs, 306 batting average, and 820 OPS with 194 hits. I'll take that. Miguel Rojas did very good for him being a defense type of player with 168 hits. Wait, what? Okay, yeah, 168 hits, a 288 batting average, and a 770 OPS. Gleyber Torres, how did you do? 898 OPS. Did go a little bit down from the trade deadline, but it's okay because he hit 39 freaking home runs. I'll take that any day. And a 280 batting average. Good, great job for Gleyber Torres. Corey Dickerson, he had 172 hits, 23 home runs, 300 batting average, and an 850 OPS. Very good, very solid season for Corey Dickerson. Garrett Cooper, he had 142 hits, 14 home runs, a 310 batting average, and 872 OPS. If you guys are still wondering why I traded Jesus Aguilar instead of him, that's the reason. So, going on. Brian Anderson did not do very good with 136 hits, 19 home runs, a 257 batting average, and a 742 OPS. I don't expect that from Brian Anderson, so moving on. Jorge Alfaro, our Gold Glove Award winner, with 128 hits, a 243 batting average, and a 725 OPS. Okay, and Harold Ramirez, how did you do? He actually did pretty good, to be honest, but his potential is going down, so that's going to hurt his value a little bit. 118 hits, 13 home runs, 271 batting average, and a 774 OPS. Okay, so let's take a look at our pitching rotation. Jordan Yamamoto, you were basically the key player in the Christian Yelich trade, I think it was, and you have not lived up to your hype, especially in this game. So with a 9 win and 17 losses, with a 4.22 ERA, that's something we gotta fix. Pablo Lopez did pretty good, 12 wins and a 3.76 ERA. Sandy Alcantara, our last All-Star last season, with 9 wins, 10 losses, and a 4.72 ERA. I mean, could be better. Caleb Smith, I mean, pretty good for the ERA, but his win-loss record is just not good. Sixto Sanchez, our prospect. How many games did he play? 15 games. Okay, where was our other pitcher? It wasn't Jose Reiner, right? It was somebody else. I don't remember, but all I know is that we got some things we got to fix in the free agency. And we got a big player coming up from the agency in Mookie Betts. So we're going to try our best to get him and get some, probably some bench players, some bullpen players, and pitching players. All right, so how did Mookie do last season? A 998 OPS with 29 home runs and 194 hits. Okay. Does he want to sign with? I mean, let's take a look. We're going to offer him $31 million. We want Mookie Betts for sure. So we're going to give him a max contract. There you go. There's a max. We're going to give him 11 years, a player option, and a backloaded payout structure. I really hope he signs with us. I think he is, since he is basically like down to play with us. Ken Giles, how did you do? 39 saves and a 2.18 ERA. Like I said, we need to fix our bullpen. So yeah, because Brandon Kinsler was not it. So yeah, we got to get Ken Giles. Let's try to get him, to be honest. Starting pitchers, that's something we really got to fix. Alex Wood did very good. Okay, I'm going to give Alex Wood a contract. How much is he asking for? 6.4. I'm going to wait out a couple of days and then I'll see. I think that's pretty much it for like the big free agents that we need in Ken Giles and Mookie Betts. So I'm going to send him a couple days and I'll let you guys know if we get him. So right away in the first day, Mookie Betts is signed with us for 11 years, $31 million. So that's a really huge signing for us. So we did lose out on Ken Giles to the Twins. Who wants to go to Minnesota instead of Miami? I understand our team is pretty eh, but still, who wants to... All right, never mind. But we got Brad Hand. He had a fantastic season last year, to be honest. He had like 52 saves, and then he had like 50-something saves, and he had a 3.06 ERA. But it's just that Ken Giles had a way better ERA and just like a teeny bit, a little more, what do you call it? Saves. Yeah, okay.
You stupid.
All right, so we literally reached our maximum roster size, so I'm going to go ahead and sim the off season. I will meet you guys in the beginning of the season, and I am pretty sure we're gonna do very well with the addition of Mookie Betts, Brad Hand, and I got a new pitcher in Alex Wood since he did do pretty good last season. So I'm hopeful we're gonna do pretty good. So fingers crossed. All right, so let's take a look at our new and improved starting lineup for the 2021 season. So let's take a look. Batting first, we got Whit Merrifield. Batting second, we got Miguel Rojas. I'm hoping for a season just like last season in hitting wise, not defense wise. His defense wise is great. I'm looking for the batting thing, not defense. Defense is important, but batting is more important than defense in my opinion. Yeah. And then we got our newly acquired Mookie Betts. He looks so good in a Miami uniform. I'm not a Miami Marlins fan, but in that game, he looks good in a Miami Marlins uniform. He would look even better if he has in a Padre uniform. Batting fourth, we got Gleyber Torres. Batting fifth, we got Corey Dickerson. Batting sixth, we got Garrett Cooper. I'm also hoping for another good season, just like last season. And then we got Brian Anderson, who I need to improve. You need to improve in batting, you, Brian. And then Jorge Alfaro, I need you to improve in batting as well. All right, pitching rotation. Alex Wood, I hope you have an amazing season. Jordan Yamamoto, please prove your hype, since you were the main piece in the Christian Yelich trade. If not, you're bonkers. Pablo Lopez, please do good. Sandy Alcantara, please do good. And Caleb Smith, please do very good. Okay, I'm going to sim to the draft because I think we have a decent spot in the draft since we didn't go plus. Not plus. We didn't go positive or whatever it's called in baseball record-wise. So I'll meet you guys in the draft. All right, we got 13th in the draft. Lucky number 13, baby. Let's go. And we got some blue chips. We got a decent amount of blue chips. I mean, we got like three. So, okay, I'll take it. Let's take a look at them. Why are all these scouts focusing on pitching? Like closers, I need fielders. I need infielders. I need starting pitchers, not freaking closers. All right, so for the first player we are gonna draft, it's gonna be Jerome France. I'm basically drafting him. Like I said, I know I said that defense isn't important as batting, which is true in my opinion, but this guy's got outstanding fielding and he's got pretty good contact. So fingers crossed, poor Jerome France. please prove me wrong. No, I don't know. I don't know how you say it. Please prove me right that you do good. And we do not have a round two pick. Okay. But we do got a competitive balance pick. And all of our green scouting accuracy is gone. Alright, so for the second player we're going to be drafted, it's going to be Robbie Irving. I mean, just look at his stats, they're fantastic. His scouting accuracy is not high, I understand, but still, this guy got some potential. And I think this is going to be our last pick for us, because yeah, we basically have no one else to pick from, and instead of just 70 overalls, which I don't want to pick, so yeah. Fingers crossed. Alright, we finished the draft. Do we get a potential? Yes, we do in Jerome France, let's go! 93 overall, but everyone else is just an eh. So, but Jerome France is a very good pick. All right, let's go. Even though he has a 2024 plus and MLB like debut wise, I mean, I could just trade him, so doesn't matter. All right, so we made it to the trade deadline. Let's take a look at our lineup to see how everyone is doing. Whit Merrifield doing very good once again with an 874 OPS, a 307 batting average, 18 home runs, and 142 hits. I mean, okay, yeah, that's very good. Miguel Rojas, please have a good batting season. Yikes. Okay. Yeah, we're just not even gonna talk about it. Mookie Betts, I mean, doing pretty good. 120 hits, 16 home runs, 310 batting average, and 935 OPS. Okay. Are we paying you $31 million for that? Sure. Why not? I mean, that's still very good. So, Gleyber Torres. And you guys were wondering why I traded Yusan Diaz for Gleyber Torres. This is why. Look at his stats. 116 hits, 32 home runs, 302 batting average, and 1,000 OPS. Okay. Next. Corey Dickerson. Okay. All right. Garrett Cooper doing very good. Okay. Let's go. Brian Anderson trying to, you know, get his reputation up and all that. So, all right. Jorge Alfaro doing very good for a catcher. So, all right. Taking a look at our pitching rotation, Alex Wood doing okay. Jordan Yamamoto, 5 ERA, okay, yeah, alright. Pablo Lopez doing pretty good. Sandy Alcantara doing pretty good as well, and Caleb Smith doing pretty good as well. Okay, now, we got some trades to do, because this is probably going to be the year that we're going to start competing. I mean, just look at our record. Look at our record. We are 4 games behind the Braves. And we're doing very good. So, no, I do not want to quit. Miguel Rojas is getting paid $5 million. I mean, it makes sense. His defense is nasty. So, I mean, I want something like in between, you know? So, I got to take a look at some shortstops. Maybe shop around. I don't even know if I'm going to trade him. Relax. I don't know if I'm going to trade him. Okay, so I did decide to trade Miguel Rojas because I think I found a good replacement in Amed Rosario. I think Amed, yeah, he is younger and is a higher overall. The thing that we're just losing with Miguel Rojas is his defense, but it's just that his contact is not there. I mean, Amed Rosario has pretty good defense as well. I mean, just look at his hitting stats though. They are way better than this. Oh yeah. Yeah, that is a definite trade for sure. And then we are also trading Hunter Harvey, someone I picked up in the Rule 5 draft. I really don't know who he is, but he's an A prospect and has a lot of trade value, so why not throw him in? And I am throwing our good old buddy Harold Ramirez because he is just not playing because, you know, the GOAT is there with Mookie. So, and we are getting a center fielder in return, so we don't have to like waste a lot of people. And he has a BA potential, so I'll just take it no matter, I guess. So, Amed Rosario, welcome to the team, and that other guy, I really don't know who you are, but still, welcome to the team. Now, I feel like this might be a dumb trade, but I might do some shopping around for Brian Anderson, because Chris Bryant is coming up in free agency next year, but I might have to clear up some space, but maybe I can get a killer third baseman right away in, like, Rafael Devers, who is having a fantastic season. While Brian Anderson had, we are losing a little bit of defense, but it's okay. Remember what I said about defense. But it's just that he is $7 million more, so we could probably throw in like Kike Hernandez, but he's doing pretty good for a bench bat. I really don't know. I'm like I said, I'm just, you know, exploring, just seeing, looking at the different options there are. Or if we can trade for Chris Bryant right away, I would totally go for it as well. I might just go for like Chris Bryant right away. Maybe throw in some prospects. I really don't know. I'll just have to, because might as well get Chris Bryant right away and get a World Series as fast as we can. All right, I decided to go for the trade, even though we are losing $6 million, but it's okay because we are getting Chris Bryant in return. Brian Anderson, I have a feeling he's going to have Chris Bryant's only 2 years older, which is perfect. So, and we're going to have free agency rights, and we are going to re-sign him, so might as well get it over with now and not have to deal with all the free agency drama and all that. So we are trading away Brian Anderson and prospect pitcher of ours in Trevor Rogers. So Chris Bryant, welcome to the team. We are just improving this team better. We're just making this team better and better. So let's take a look. Yeah, we are definitely making this team better and better. He does have a down year this year, but I mean, it's okay. It's Chris Bryant. I'll take it anytime. And I think that's it for trades. We are in a good budget. Yeah, so I think that's it for trades. I mean, we do gotta re-sign Chris Bryant. That's a for sure ski. So we'll give him 5 years. Why not? And we're gonna go for the lowest amount of money possible. All right, we re-signed Chris Bryant back for like $18 million. I don't remember. Let me check. Yeah, we're basically signing for like 18 mil a year. Something like that. I don't really remember. But yeah, I think we should be good. And how much? Yeah, we still got Will Merrifield for like 3 more years. Brad Hand is pretty disappointing though. So that's a little shock. Okay, and then I'm also gonna trade our closer, Brad Hand. I mean, he is doing very good. But I mean, he is just not what we paid him to do. Like, while we can get Roberto Ozuna, who has a 0.65 ERA and 36 saves this season. So I prefer to keep that. So I hate him as a person, but as a ball player, he is very good. So Roberto Ozuna, welcome to the team. I hope you're doing the same thing you're doing right now. So, okay. And I think we gotta re-sign Roberto Ozuna. So give me 1 second. All right, we re-signed Roberto Ozuna for like, I don't know. I really just go for the lowest amount of money possible, so I don't really check the number. But yeah, there you go. Make your calculations. So, all right. I think we should be good for trade. Now, that's for sure. I think we're good for trades for now because we are going to re-sign Gleyber Torres for a huge contract next season. So, well, not contract, but like he's got arbitration for 2 more years. So, his contract, his money, the amount of money he's going to be asking for is going to be huge. So, all right, I'm gonna sit the whole season and hopefully we'll make the playoffs. All right, there we go. We finished 162 and we won our division and we're gonna be taking on the Brewers in the division series. So let's take a look on how everyone else did. We won by 6 games. Okay, and who is the wild card? There we go. The Padres made it to the wild card and the Braves. Let's check the league awards. Let's see. Chris Bryant and Mookie Betts won Gold Gloves. Let's go. And obviously, you know, delivery man of the year is going to be Roberto Ozuna. I mean, let's take a look. He had a 1.16 ERA and 55 saves. That is crazy. And 70 strikeouts. You know, it's not under one, but I'll still take it. I'll still take it. And for the league leaders, Amed Rosario in doubles, Whit Merrifield in hits, Chris Bryant on bases on balls, okay. And okay, obviously, and then Roberto Ozuna on saves. All right, first game of the playoffs, we are against the Milwaukee Brewers, obviously. So Pablo Lopez versus Brandon Woodruff, we won that one. Sandy Alcantara versus Freddy Peralta, we lost, okay. Alex Wood versus Adrian Hauser, okay. Then Jordan Yamamoto versus Eric Lauer, I have a bad feeling. Oh, Jordan Yamamoto actually went out. 7 innings, okay. Not get a single hit. Okay, let's go. And now Pablo Lopez versus Brandon Woodruff for the last game, I believe. Yes. And we won against him in the first game. Brandon Woodruff was pitching, so there we go. And now we are against the Dodgers. Oh my god. I think this is an L, boys. Alright. Sandy Alcantara versus Clayton Kershaw. Alright, not surprised. Alex Wood versus Julio Urias. All right, I'm actually pretty surprised about that one. Jordan Yamamoto versus Dustin May. Oh, this has to be a win. All right, moving on. We got Pablo Lopez versus Walker Buehler. Okay. So we lose against Dustin May, but we win against Walker Buehler. That makes no sense, but okay, moving on. Caleb Smith versus Clayton Kershaw. All right, we lost. And then Sandy Alcantara versus David Price. We won that one. This is the last game. Winner goes to the World Series. So Alex Wood versus Julio Urias. And we won, baby. Let's go. That was tight. That was very tight. And now we are against Boston in the World Series. This is crazy. So let's go. Pablo Lopez versus Chris Sale. Chris Sale is going off right now. So, and we won. The ones I'm always think we're going to lose, we win. But okay. Sandy Alcantara versus Colin McHugh. We won that one. Alex Ford versus Eduardo Rodriguez. Please don't tell me I smell a sweep right now. Not in the second season. Jordan Yamamoto versus Martin Perez. We swept Boston in the World Series. I'm happy. I am very happy. Chris Bryant wins the playoff MVP, obviously. World Series MVP goes to Alex Wood. What? Only because he got like one hit? I mean, I guess. That was so quick. I wanted to keep going. But, I mean, I guess this is basically where the video is saying quit. So, I mean, maybe I can go one more season. But, I mean, the point is to win one World Series and I did it. So, yeah. If you guys really enjoyed this video and want to see more like this, obviously maybe they're going to be longer or maybe there might just be one season. You may never know. So if you guys want to see more videos like this and maybe more content in the future, hit that subscribe button and hit that bell notification right next to it so you can be notified every time I upload. So I am logging off. Please leave a like, comment, and subscribe. And I'm out.